Right. Well, yes, you're making this place sound rather formidable. And, well, if I'm new and you're suggesting to take the safe routes, and I'm doing the work of the Empire, safe doesn't sound like it's going to be in my, my itinerary. Anyway, let's speak to someone. Fargoth. Fargoth. Hello, Fargoth. Are you the one they dropped off? Odd to see a boat arrive at that time of day. Hope the Imperials treated you okay. I swear they took my ring. Okay. What about your ring? I did find a ring. I swear one of the guards has it. I had it last week before their weekly Let's Shake Down Fargoth ritual. An engraved healing ring, a family heirloom of mine. You haven't seen it, have you? Yes, I found it. Found it? Here, take it. Well, you found it. Amazing. Thank you. Thank you. You are now my favorite friend. I'll be sure to tell others, especially my friend Ariel, who runs the trade house here. Go see him. He'll be happy to see you now. Oh, there we go. We've made a friend. So, what's the word around here? I've heard that the local tax collector, Processus Vitellius, is missing. No surprise, really. He wasn't well liked around here. Yeah, that is tax collectors for you. So, obviously, you know I'm new here. Got any advice? Don't head for the back country until you're ready. I did, and they took my stuff, and I count myself lucky. There's plenty of work, good opportunities near towns down here in the southwest. But Red Mountain? No way. Out east with the Telvanni? Not yet. Up north in Shiogorad? Just toss your stuff in the water and slit your throat. It'll be much faster and less painful. Charming. So, you know, I helped you out with the ring. Know any little secrets around the place? If you're thinking of travelling up country near Shiogorad, or out more like a Morway, or inside the ghost fence, you'll need to know about corpus. It's a disease that turns normal creatures into beasts, turns men into twisted, mad lumps of flesh, superhumanly strong and full of hatred. You get corpus from fighting with diseased creatures. It's hard to get corpus, but harder to get rid of it. In fact, I hear there is no cure. Good to know. Okay, well, you've pretty much told me about the interesting places in here, so I'll leave you to it. And I know there is a test subject around here, just to make sure that the hand-to-hand combat is going to go fine. And I will save here. Because this could go very wrong. Thanks, RNG. Very wrong. Just see if I can do any sneaking at all. Every little helps. And that didn't work. Ow. Okay. Well, that wasn't too bad. Okay, that hurt a little more. Now it's starting to hurt. As you can see, this is definitely a slapping motion. Already leveling up our hand-to-hand skill. That's nice to know. And there we go. We've knocked the fatigue down, and it's now just a matter of finishing the job. This is how a lot of the, well, in fact, all of our fights are going to go. Come on, there we go. Well, that was a little more painful than I was hoping it to be, but could have been worse. Oh, nothing here. Nothing on there. Yep, I'll take that. And I'll take that. And a dragon tail. I'll take that as well. And there's a cloth sack in here. Fancy that. With 2 gold. Now, if I'm not mistaken, in an unmodded vanilla game of Morrowind, there's usually an axe in here. Correct me if I'm wrong, but if I remember correctly, it was either silver or it was magical or something along those lines. And it's basically the game's way of letting you have an item that you can use to fight spooky things early on in the game, assuming that you found it. So yeah, as you may notice, the layout of Seyda Neen is slightly different from where it normally is. And that's from the, I believe it's from the Morrowind Rebirth mods that I'm using. Admittedly, I did the very sensible thing of installing a bunch of mods all at the same time without testing them, because that's just what you do. But I did test them afterwards, just to make sure that it was stable, and for the most part it was. And that graphical glitch that I was talking about earlier does not seem to be... Oh yeah, it is. Yeah, look at this post. It's basically casting a weird reflection on the water here. I don't know how to adjust that. If anyone knows, just, yeah, comment, make me aware of it. You know, how to fix this, because it does look a little bit weird. But I've got a feeling that there's not much I'm going to be able to do about that. I am using the... Frankie. Yeah, it gets a little bit... mind-bending. Maybe it's just the hist that I've consumed. Who knows? Yeah. The graphical fidelity mods that I'm using are it's not the one that everyone was going on about in, I think it was 2017, 2018. There was one graphical overhaul mod that all the games magazines were. Games journalism outlets were babbling on about and saying it was making Morrowind look realistic. When, I mean, it was good, but didn't make it look realistic. But the mods that I am using are sort of more optimized for the 2022 experience. I'll have to... Oh, hello. Oh, I knew it was around somewhere. I didn't realise it was this close. Oh, Processus Vitellius. How I know that just from looking at a corpse, I don't know, but... 200 gold. Some nice clothes. or nicer clothes. Let's not completely rob corpse of its things. Right, let's be at least mildly respectful of the dead. There's a mud crab. Let's see if I can get the drop on it. I doubt I will, but who knows? Might get lucky. I won't get lucky. And let the slapping commence. Now, Morrowind Graphics Extender. That was the mod that I'm using for the graphical fidelity here. One for a good measure. Oh, there we go. That's another foe defeated. It didn't hurt as much as the rock crab did earlier, so that's nice. Yeah, one thing to note about the Twin Lamps, I think it's Twin Lamps Revisited mod, that expands on the Twin Lamps story that was cut from Morrowind. They've added these towers here, but unfortunately a lot of them, the way in is slightly offset, and not exactly the most friendly way to invite people in. Sorry. So yeah, that let's just pretend that's not a thing. I could probably go into an editor and fix that myself, but there are quite a few of those towers, and I don't know where all of them are just yet. Anyway, seeing as Fargoth here is our new best friend, let's talk about the murder of Processus Vitellius. You found his body, huh? Well, it's up to you what to do with that information. I suppose a Gala in the Census and Excise office would be the one to tell, if that's your inclination. That's true. Okay, let's do just that. Hello. I would like to report a murder. I've just landed in this strange country of Morrowind, and within an hour, I'm already here to report the murder of your tax collector. It totally wasn't me. Murdered? What a waste. And Processus was a good man. I had been wondering why we hadn't heard from him in a few days. Still, these are dangerous times we live in, and these sorts of things will happen. Did you happen to find the tax money he collected? I hate to be so callous, but I do have a job to do. So, what do you guys think I should do here? Shall I give him the 200 septums that I found, or just conveniently forget that I picked that up? Well, I mean, I'm probably going to get into trouble with the law fairly frequently, seeing as I'm intent in stopping slavery wherever I can. So getting on the law's good side right now is probably a good idea. Yes, I found 200 septums on his body. You did? How odd that it, he was murdered but not robbed. Your honesty is appreciated. I can tell you that. I won't forget this, as it spanks the wayward. In fact, if you're looking for some money for yourself, I'd like to see the murderer of Processus punished. Killing an emperor's tax collector is punishable by death. Find his murderer, bring him to justice, and the census and excise office will pay you 500 septums. Well, I mean, that's more than the 200 I just gave him, so yeah, why not? Let's go murderer hunting. Probably not going to end well for us, but... well, no guts, no glory. So, Let's ask someone else about this now. What do you know about the murder of Processus, Vitellius? Someone finally got him, eh? Well... it's no surprise, I suppose. No one likes a tax collector, especially one who flaunts his wealth while taking our hard-earned cash. This is coming from an Imperial Legion member here. Only one who could stomach him at all was Favere over in the lighthouse. The two of them spent some time together. It's a shame, really. She seemed like a nice woman. Okay. Very well. So, we get to be the ones to announce Processus's murder to his only friend. Well, I have some bad news, I'm afraid. So, Spanks the Wayward, you're new to Seyda Neen, and you'd like to like some help finding your way around? Very sensible. Go ahead, ask away. Looking for services? Some specific place? Someone in particular? Or just need a little advice? Whatever it is, I'm happy to help. Well, I have something to tell you, in fact. Processus Vitellius is dead. Processus murdered? No, tell me it's not so. He was the gentlest man I've ever met. He and I had come so close in the past few months. I don't know what I would do without him. I've only seen him get angry once or twice and never raised a hand to anyone. It is so sad. Seen him get angry? Against who? Well, not even angry, I suppose. I saw him arguing once with Foreign Glynneth about his taxes. I thought Processus had been levying too much. Oh, he thought Processus had been levying too much and skimming off the top for himself. Ridiculous. Processus would never have done such a thing, I'm sure of it. Please find out what happened, friend, and if you... find out what became of Processus' ring, it would ease my heart. Okay, his ring? I gave him the ring many months ago, and it was dear to him. I would like it to remember him by. Oh dear, so... she gave him... a rather nice ring. And now the people were thinking he was skimming off the top. And flaunting his wealth. Oh, oh dear. Mistakes were made. And the Wraith's wedding dowry. I won't read these. I can read them if there is called for it, but for the time being, I'll just let these be. Right. Now, next. I think I grabbed some of those. No, I didn't. Okay. There is a reason other than alchemy why I'm picking these up. So, I could go to Warren's shack right now. I don't know though, because I mean, I'm now an agent of the Empire and given permission to kill the murderer of a tax collector. So, obviously they have the ability to fight. And obviously I'm still very... Follow trees... Oh, right, yeah, okay. We'll come back to that later. We're still very much new. I don't think we'll last very long in a fight against people. So, I'm going to do a little bit of fighting, just to get my skill up a bit. Fighting the local wildlife, that is. Because, yeah, I'm not confident in my abilities right now. I'm sticking with hand-to-hand combat, so... it's probably not going to go too well for me. Sneak, sneak, sneak. Oh, that sort of worked. Oh, here comes the missing streak. Ah, there we go. We're hitting again. Ow. 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 Come on. Slap some more. My goodness. Oh, Morrowind and your RNG. I think we've been spoiled by Oblivion and Skyrim. Oh, there we go. Oh, my fatigue is really low. Okay, he's dead. Thank goodness. I'll heal up once I've got my fatigue back. Oh, okay. I haven't seen this before. That's rather grim, he says as he loots the corpse. And there's a soul gem. Nice. We're going to need those. A glass bottle. Wonder what the story of this poor soul is. I better walk. Make sure I get that fatigue up. Thanks for not helping. I was able to level up my hand-to-hand combat. That guard there does have a habit of joining in on any fights that occur around here, which is useful to know if you get into a bit of a pickle. Okay, there we go. Fatigue's good. I can finally start healing. And there we go. So, yeah, I can't remember if there is a way to enchant an item that gives me a permanent magic. Ooh, I haven't seen this before either. With 13 gold in it. Fair enough. I don't know if we can regenerate magicka with an enchanted item. I know we can do it with potions, so that's going to be an option at some point. I'm fairly certain that there are spell effects for regenerating fatigue and health, but I don't think they are spell effects you can actually learn. I think they're tied to specific characters in one of the expansions. I can't remember the details, though. I had been planning this playthrough a few weeks ago, but it's only until now that I've actually had the opportunity to start it. So a lot of my planning is from way back then. And I'm just trying to get back into the swing of things. Hopefully I'll start remembering more of the stuff as we go along. Anyway. None. Thanks. Elf. Anyway, let's go in here, sell some stuff that we've found. Welcome to Ariel's Trade House. I barter for goods or coin. I also have a small selection of spells for sale. No credit. You want a little advice? That's free. That's all that's free. Would you like to hear about our most popular potions or most popular scrolls? If you're offering advice, if you want to live to a ripe old age, buy a weapon and as much armor as you can wear. And still run from trouble. Buy a spell or two and practice your skills. Don't practice on citizens. We call that foul murder. We don't like it. But you can kill smugglers and bandits and other outlaws all you like. Outlaws have no rights. Hence the name outlaw. Outside of the law, yes. Plenty of adventurers make a living from killing and looting outlaws. That smuggler scum down at Adamas Hartus, for instance. Hint, hint. The cave down near the Silk Strider platform. Hint, hint. Yes, thanks for telling me. I did see it. I'm not going anywhere near it right now, though. So, what's the word around here? I heard that Hriskar's upstairs is having some financial troubles. Can't seem to win a wager these days. Well, yeah, that would be his financial troubles, wouldn't it? So what potions do you have? Cure common disease and cure blight disease potions. They're the most popular with travellers. Fortify strength, endurance, speed, agility. Very helpful in combat. Fortify personality is popular with merchants and shy persons. Of course, Fortify Fatigue keeps you fighting at your best. Restore Health and Restore Fatigue are perhaps our most popular items, and a short burst of power during a fight. You can't beat Grief, Sheen, Flynn, Master, and Sujima. Okay. I'm going to assume those are how those are pronounced. I've never actually heard those being pronounced, come to think of it. Maybe I heard about it in Elder Scrolls Online, very briefly, but I can't remember. We've got a nice selection of potions, but what about your scrolls? Vigor and Vitality are your best-selling bargain items, restoring fatigue and health, respectively. On CV Intervention and Divine Interventions, transport you instantly to the nearest temple or nearest imperial shrine. Good for routine or emergency transportation. Heartwise helps with persuasion. Summon Skeletal Minion brings help in a jiffy, and Drathus's Winter Guest does a lot of damage at a touch. Handy to whittle a too tough opponent down to size. So, what was that about practicing skills? Practice on creatures and outlaws, and anyone who attacks you first. When in doubt, run away. And if you attack a citizen by accident, don't kill him. Turn yourself into a guard and pay your fine, clear your name. Or people will treat you like an outlaw. Understandable. Well, enough of the chatter. We are here for barter. You'll see our reputation with him is already pretty high. That will be Fargoth's doing, I believe. That's nice to know. What about those shoes? I don't wear shoes, so 1 gold, that's nice. Get rid of these weapons. I won't be using them. I don't think I'll be able to barter with those. Oh, and anything else while I'm here? No. I mean, I guess I could sell the Flynn, but that might be useful. So yeah, although I have a rough idea of what I'm going to be doing, I am open to suggestions from anyone in the chat or in the comments when I upload this to YouTube. So yes, do let me know if there's something that you think I could be doing better, or if you have any plans to help me improve the build. Now, as it stands right now, I think I am good. I don't need a robe. Tempted to buy greaves. Or maybe get the gauntlets. I mean, I know I'm going unarmored mostly, but having a little bit of protection. Plus, there is another reason other than the fact that there's endurance tied to the skilling up, leveling up the heavy armor skill. It's a little bit of meta going on here, a little bit of optimization going on, game knowledge. In the far future, I will be encountering something that I will need to wear. So I think it's at least fitting to wear the gauntlets. Yeah, I will wear these, but maybe I'll gain the reputation and name of being Steel Fist rather than Spanx the Wayward. I doubt it, though. But this cost, I might be able to barter down a little bit. Yes, I can. Now, I know my mercantile skin is rubbish right now, so no, I can't push it. And there we go. Steel gauntlets, one on each hand. There we go. Very nice. So, you mentioned Hriskar. Hi. Yeah, you look like you could use a friend, Outlander. Perhaps I could be your friend. I'd like you to help me recover some gold. Right, okay, so this is how you treat friends in Vardenfell. That's right. See, I had a bad run of luck playing nine holes and lost a bit of money. Normally I'd be fine. We can usually keep some gold in our pockets just from the money the locals pay us for protection. But I know some of them are holding out on me, especially that little fetcher Fargoth. He's come up light in the past couple of weeks when I've been, when I've shaken him down. I know he's stashing it somewhere. I'd like you to find Fargoth's hiding place. Fargoth's hiding place? Yeah, I know the little fetcher's got, one somewhere. Just not sure where yet. Now, I've already gone through his whole house, so I know he's not hiding it there. I'd like you to find out where he's stashing his gold. If you can, I'll give you a share of the wealth. Are you up for it? Yeah, I'll do it. Excellent. Here's what I want you to do. Not sure where he goes, but I know he wanders around town at night. Watch his movements. Best vantage point is atop the lighthouse south of town. That'll give you a nice view of all of Seyda Neen. If you keep an eye on where he goes, I'm sure you'll be able to figure out where he's hiding that gold. And there we go. So, there's a non-combat quest for us. But that's going to be some time away. So it's only 11 a.m. And if my timescale cheat is actually working, we're progressing at a much slower rate than we normally would. I don't think there's anything gameplay related that slowing the time of day down breaks. But I just find it a little more comfy if the days don't last like 1 hour. Because admittedly, I do like to play this at a slower pace. And there's a rock crab again. Fairly certain that I killed this chap. Oh well. I guess they respawn fairly quickly if you dispose of the corpses. Oh, he spotted me. Definitely working on that hand-to-hand skill. Which is nice. Let's remember not to go too quickly on these in these fights. And now that I'm getting closer to that 50 skill points in hand-to-hand, it's becoming a lot more likely that I'll hit, so I can start pacing myself a little better with the fights, rather than just spamming left click all the time. So, over there, I can just about make out tomb. That'll be somewhere we want to explore at some point. Clear out the dead in there. Undead. Now, do you think I could take on this chap? Warren, yeah. Keep forgetting his name. It's unfortunate. Yeah, let's give it a go. So, you. What do you want? I'm here to talk about the murder of Processus Vitellius. That Fetcher? You're damn right I did him in. A good thing, too. He was skimming a load of money from all us honest people, overcharging us on our taxes and keeping the difference for himself. He was always flaunting his money around, showing off his new clothes and jewels. So I killed the bastard, left the body out there to rot, with all his ill-begotten gold still on him. Yeah. I mean, I'm not a fan of tax collectors either, but it's no excuse to kill a man. Your punishment's been decided. You're one of them, huh? Come to kill me? Well, give it your best shot, Argonian. I've no problem spilling more of the blood of the Emperor's lackeys. What a shame.
You will die.
There we go. Well, that worked. So, yeah. Now, if anyone was wondering why I find, why I named this character Spanx the Wayward, well, I found the most accurate way of hitting a downed enemy is by, yeah, attacking there. So, there's that. I mean, there are other places, I guess, but it seems like this is where I get the most reliable hits. Because, I mean, you don't really quite know where the hitbox is, and we've leveled up. We need to be careful with my fatigue now. I say as I start slapping like crazy again. Do I have anything that improves my fatigue? Oh my goodness, he actually hit me pretty hard. He's not going down. Oh, there we go. Now, I was in two minds about this one, but one of the mods that I've used just as a quality of life thing did give me the option of making the alchemy components always successful when you consume them. And they give you the first bonus or malice that ingredient has on them. Now, I was in two minds about doing this. And I can disable it in the future if you think I deserve the extra challenge. But yeah, I can, next time I start the game up, I can disable that particular feature the next time. But yeah, I need that fatigue back, so we'll eat some more food. You're running around like crazy now. There we go. Fatigue. Yeah, definitely need to work on it. But it does mean that there is more use in food items, because I don't know if it's just a case of confirmation bias, but I did a bit of testing, and I didn't seem to get the restore fatigue bonus guaranteed from eating food, which seems a little bit weird to me. I mean, the whole point of food is to restore yourself. So there we go. We basically tortured a man by pummeling him to death. And best part of this is, well, this was his house, and now it is my house. Here, I'll wear the belt. Might as well. How do those trousers look? There. Put the others up back on. Now processes his ring. Might as well grab all the bits and dispose of the chap. 18 gold, excellent. Ah, I could have always raided these as well during the fight. Man, these games make you do weird things. Can you imagine that? You're just in the middle of a fight, you're getting tired, and then you just rummage through some guy's food stores and just start stuffing your face in the middle of the fight. I mean, that's even weirder than the whole Skyrim meme of just scarfing down hundreds of wheels of cheese in the middle of a fight. Anyway, it was the lass over at the lighthouse who wanted to see the ring, so let's hand it back to her. She says, this is ring. Oh, you found the ring I gave him? Thank you so much. Spanks the wayward. It's good to have something to remember him by, though I'll never see him again. Here, take this. He usually travelled with a couple when he was doing his job, but he didn't this last time. If only he had. So, got some health potions in exchange for a ring. Well, I mean, useful, but probably not the best trade. Yeah, back to the old chap who greeted me to this place. So, the murder of Processus Vitellius has been avenged. I heard you've been asking around about his murder. I'm glad to see this matter brought to its completion. Here's your reward, Spanks the Wayward. Good to see that there are still some citizens who understand their loyalty to our Emperor. Well, I mean, kind of. 500 gold was nice. Right. Onwards. So now that we've done a little more than evict the chap from his house, that house is pretty much ours, that we can use as a place of storage now, if we need to. Ooh, Dance in the Fire, Chapter 6. And then that's improved our mercantile skill. Excellent. So, we've got a bit of a wait to go. We still have to find out Falgoth's hiding place. So we'll say we'll rest. It's midday now. So if we rest 8 hours now, it should give us time to get to the lighthouse and see what's up. You're ascended to level 2. Realize that all your life has been coasting along as if you were in a dream. Suddenly, facing the trials of the last few days, you've come alive. Okay, so we can level up the speed and personality. I mean, might as well. The speed's very nice. I'm not a big fan of how slow the game feels with you just ambling along. Especially if you are having to walk around because running drains you too much fatigue. But anyway, enough griping about that. I was considering using a cheat to buff my speed. I still might. I doubt I will, though. I'll see what the consensus is on that. But for now, I'm not going to use it. I'm just going to carry on as Bethesda intended. And the last point, when it can go into strength, I don't think that actually affects your damage with hand-to-hand combat skill. Someone correct me if I'm wrong there. But for now, I really could use the extra health and the maximum fatigue. That would be nice. So, there we go. It is now 8 p.m. Just quick save. I'm probably just going to do that at random. Just quick save. Not just before I know I'm going into a dangerous situation, but I will be quick saving at random points just so the game doesn't decide, I've had enough now, I'm going to stop. Because, well, Bethesda. And up we go. Ooh. And it's raining. Not ideal. But this is a good enough hiding spot. And, for those of you who are familiar with Morrowind, you've undoubtedly come across this quest before. Speaking with Hriskar and trying to find Fargoth. And you'll see this scene. You can just see how Morrowind Rebirth is. Well, I'm pretty certain it was Morrowind Rebirth that has reorganized the towns. And you can see just how much it's expanded Seyda Neen. And putting a tree right there. And I think they, whoever made this mod put that tree there on purpose. Because previously you used to be able to see Fargoth sort of sneaking around in the middle of town. I mean, I don't know why you would want to change the quest like that in a mod. On a quest like this that's so early in the game, pretty much everyone knows it at this point. But anyway, how is everyone doing? Hope you're doing well. And it is now dark already. Well, hopefully I haven't missed our opportunity to watch Fargoth. But I pretty much know what to do. But yeah, how is everyone doing? Hope you're doing well. No, Hogan is not feeling so good right now. Possibly a cold. Hopefully it is just a cold and nothing worse. Preferably something even milder. Maybe it's just an off day. Now, a little while back I had a rough throat after streaming, and the day after it was quite nasty, so I had to rest the following day. I was hoping to do some streaming, but I called it off that day. It took me by surprise at just how easy it is to mess your throat up just from streaming. Still, I'm learning. Still early days for me yet. Oh, everyone's still just meandering around out there. No sign of Fargoth yet. While that's going on, it's probably going to mess the game up a little bit, so I will save, and I will quickly hop into OBS to make sure things are looking good. Yep. We're doing okay, I think. Yep, the stream's looking good. All happy hunky-dory. I'm getting antsy. I don't think you actually have to witness Fargoth putting his money into his hiding place. I think it needs to just happen. It's getting quite dark. I believe that is something else that I have done with this game. I have made the nights darker, which may be a mistake for streaming, but I don't know, it seems a little weird to have bright nights unless it's a full moon or something. And, well, I mean, there's a lot of clouds overhead, so we don't see any moon. Still no sign of Fargoth. Oh, that was a mistake.